It's true, the Galaxy S24 is way more powerful in the US than in the UK and Europe. Samsung has traditionally had an annoying habit of splitting its chipset offering with its flagship Galaxy S series, with the UK and Europe getting a Samsung Exynos-enabled phone, while those in the US get a Qualcomm variant. That changed with last year's Galaxy S23, with the entire range running the Snapdragon 8 Gen 2 for Galaxy, regardless of where it was purchased. But it looks like it was too good to be true. That's because Samsung has once again reverted to its chipset split with the launch of this year's Galaxy S24 range. That means that those in the UK and Europe get the Exynos 2400 powered phone, while those in the US get the Snapdragon 8 Gen 3 for Galaxy. At the briefing event I attended ahead of its launch, Samsung reassured me that the two chipsets were on a par, not only in terms of power, but also efficiency. However, after getting my hands on the Snapdragon 8 Gen 3 powered Galaxy S24 to compare to the Exynos 2400 equipped version, I have seen firsthand that this is simply not the case. The gap in performance is best showcased by the chipset's GPUs. Running GFX Bench Aztec Ruins on high settings to simulate high-level 3D gaming at 1080p, the Exynos S24 managed a respectable 85fps, but it's dwarfed by the Snapdragon's 111fps. It's a similar story in the GFX Bench Car Chase benchmark, with the Snapdragon's 120fps beating the Exynos's 100fps. That's a considerable gap considering the two have identical specs aside from the processor. Moving over to 3DMark Wildlife Extreme, a more graphically intense GPU test that runs a high-end 3D game at 4K, the Exynos variant scored 3,957, while the Snapdragon clocked in at 5,016, a difference of over 1,000 points. A key feature of both the Snapdragon 8 Gen 3 and Exynos 2400 is ray tracing, though as you probably guessed by now, the Snapdragon offers better performance here too. Using 3DMark's new Ray Trace Solar Bay benchmark, the Snapdragon managed an average of 32fps compared to just 27fps from the Exynos competition. The difference isn't quite as stark in the CPU department, with the Snapdragon and Exynos scores in Geekbench 6 pretty much in line with one another. This suggests that it's in the gaming department where you'll really notice the difference between the two chipsets, with similarly speedy day-to-day performance when scrolling through TikTok, sending emails, and browsing the web. The only saving grace is that, with both chipsets built on the same 4nm process, there isn't much difference in terms of battery efficiency, as determined by our standard battery test of playing a HDR movie on Netflix for an hour. Even with arguably more parity than with previous chipset splits, we're once again in a situation where US users are effectively getting a much more capable smartphone than the rest of the world, and that's frustrating. It's worth noting that the chipset split only applies to the Samsung Galaxy S24 and the larger S24 Plus. Oddly enough, the top-end Samsung Galaxy S24 Ultra comes with the Snapdragon 8 Gen 3 for Galaxy worldwide. It's almost like Samsung itself knew which chipset was better ahead of its launch. So is this something that you really care about, or are you just going to buy the S24 regardless? Let me know your thoughts in the comments. So will this affect your decision to buy a Samsung Galaxy S24? Let me know your thoughts in the comments, and don't forget to subscribe.